What'd you say? No, not at all. Just because I chose to spend my Friday night with my wife, now I'm caught up. Yeah, y'all crazy, man. What the hell? No, I wasn't talking to you. But let me call you right back, though. All right.
I know this ain't the way you picture leaving. We got to this point because you gave so many reasons. I look at you and hate the very bed you lay sleeping. Can't nobody have you like I had you, and I mean it. I play for keeps. I thought I told you not to ever come and play with me. On the other end of this aggression, I would hate to be. I love you so much, can you?
Try to tell me to slow down, but I'm way too far gone. I'm way too far gone. I'm way too far gone.
Way too far.
I'm way too
far. Try to tell me to slow down, but I'm
way too far gone.
Way too far.
I'm way too far gone.
Way too far gone.
I'm way too far gone.
Way too far gone.
I'm way too.
I'm in my prime.
I'm in my prime.
Gotta go and get mine.
no sign. This opportunity is way too hard to find, yeah.
I just don't know why you can't take me seriously, bro. Am I or am I not a paying client?
I mean, I would if you would act like one.
What are you talking about, man? I've done everything that you've told me to do. I'm more open, I'm more polite. I don't brush off people's feelings. I tell people exactly how I feel. So what are you talking about? You're starting to sound like a hater.
Tobias, you only hear what you want to hear. And you only see what you want to see. Anything else doesn't even matter.
What?
What, is that too much for you to comprehend?
Oh man, I'm smarter than you.
See, look, this is why I told you to get a therapist that's not your closest friend.
Shane, you're not my closest friend.
Then who am I?
My best friend. Come on, man, where are you going?
Man, it's past 4:00. Your session is over. Yeah, I'm heading out. What, you need a blanket? You gonna stay tonight? See, you childish.
Is he true? You already know the deal, yeah. You know where to find me.
I ain't gonna keep these shots for too long. I'll take all three of them.
Man, where y'all been?
Man?
Nothing much. Waiting on y'all. Right, y'all been moving slow.
What up, man?
Here you go, bro. Appreciate you.
Yeah, it took us a minute. My last client of the day held us up, asking dumb questions.
Let me guess. Your last client was Tobias.
I can't even tell you. That violates my client confidentiality.
I was the last client, and what about it?
Nothing, man.
All right, good, because I just want to kick it with my boys. Huh?
Yeah,
all right, man. And forget about how crazy this week's been.
I get it. We'll take these shots. I got us some shots. Cheers to the week.
Cheers.
So what's up, man? You look kind of down. What's going on with you?
Nah, bro, I just kind of feel like something's missing. Like, I need companionship.
Companionship? You need a dog?
I'm looking for, like, somebody I can connect with. Like, on a intimate and intellectual level.
Nah.
Somebody that can challenge me.
You got me lost.
I'm looking for the one.
See? I knew it. Hey, this reminds me of the old Tobias. Remember when he used to think that he was gonna marry every chick that gave him the time of day?
Wait, now that I think about it, how many girls did you fall for back in high school?
Man, it was only like 3. Okay, 5. It's more like 7.
Yeah, yeah.
7.
Exactly.
Man, whatever, bro, but at least when I love them, they love me back.
Chill, bro, chill.
It's all right, Quincy, man. We know you had hella girls.
Thank you.
Problem was, we never got a chance to meet any of them.
See, what we not finna do is gang up on me all night.
Hey, Shane. Hey, Tobias.
Jesse.
Quincy, when you come pick up the kids this week, be on time. I got somewhere I'm trying to be.
Desi, you know I'm always on time. Can we talk about this another time? You see, I'm just trying to chill. Dang.
Chilling. That's all you ever want to do is chill. Never want to take care of your responsibility. That's how we got kids in the first place.
Responsibility? Girl, I take care of my responsibilities. Why don't you take yourself back over to whatever ghetto friends you came from? I'm with the guys. We can talk about this later.
I'm about to go get a drink.
Please.
And just so that you know, my phone will be on Do Not Disturb. So don't be calling me like you was last time.
What?
Don't be calling me like you was last time.
Bro, how's she gonna put her phone on Do Not Disturb? We got kids. It could be an emergency.
Yeah, and on that note, I'm going to the bathroom.
Yeah, can I get 3 crown shots, please?
Didn't see you standing there.
Hey, you know you have a really gorgeous smile?
You think so?
I do. I'm Tobias.
I'm Nia.
It's nice to meet you, Nia.
It's nice to meet you as well, Tobias.
Nia. I'm sorry.
What's up, T?
What up, Q?
Nah, what's up with you? And what happened to you last night?
What's me?
The girl from last night.
Oh, that was nothing, bro. She was cool. She had a banging body, but I probably won't call her.
What? I thought she'd be something different, especially by the way you've been talking about finding the one.
Hey, there you go.
So what was it?
I don't know, man. Like, she was cool on the surface, but like everybody else I've met lately, you go deeper than that and there's just nothing there.
You only know this girl for 2 seconds. If you're about to have a 30-year-old midlife crisis, that's something you're gonna have to call Shane about.
You don't understand because you got kids. If you worked out whatever little nonsense going on between you and Destiny, you could actually have a family. It's not like that for me.
I get it, man. I really do. So what about this weekend? Kevin's having a birthday party. We should go. We can meet some new girls there. But hey, if not, at least it's a way to get your mind off of all of this around here.
Look, man, I'm not gonna fight you on having a good time.
It's my boy.
I'm just glad you made it out tonight. Who's watching your kids?
Man, hopefully Desi. Why'd you have to bring something?
What you mean? It's just a little bottle of champagne.
That's not what they gonna think. They gonna think I should have brought something.
Why didn't you bring something?
It's a birthday party. They already got everything.
Man, we just gonna tell them that we went in on this together.
Bet. That's perfect.
Yeah. Hey, hold on. Where's Shane?
I don't know, man. He's probably tired of hearing you crying all y'all sessions. You gotta chill.
Come on, bro. Well, listen, you know Kevin is sensitive, so when we get in there, let's just make it seem like Shane really wanted to be here, but he genuinely could not make it.
That's perfect. We don't really want to ruffle any feathers. Plus, look, it's a birthday party. You got the drink. We're gonna have a good time.
Hey, I like the way you talking, man.
Yes, sir. Let's go.
Hey, let's get it, man.
What up, fellas?
Kev! Happy birthday, man. Oh, you getting old on me.
What's up, man?
Happy birthday.
I appreciate that. Thank you, man. Where's Shane?
He couldn't make, you know, sessions and everything, but he wanted us to tell you happy birthday from me and him, man. Happy birthday.
Speaking of which, this is from us.
Oh,
yeah, we went 50-50
that.
On that.
50-50, so that means you bought it. That's what I'm talking about,
man. Man, I'll chill out, man.
You know Quincy Cheap, he ain't buying nothing, man. Hey, yo, man, how's work been?
Oh, man, there's just been a load of investigations, so.
Speaking of investigations, I may need you to investigate my baby mama. Can you do that for free, right? What, y'all know I might need that?
Boy, bro. Come on,
listen, the only thing we need to be investigating tonight is these ladies.
Man.
Yes, sir.
Let me tell you, I done already pulled a couple profiles, so if y'all need to know something, holla at me. You feel
oh,
me?
Oh, already?
That's what I'm talking about.
Well, check it out, Kevin. It's your birthday, so first three is free, and the rest is all on me.
Because, you know, Tobias can't talk to no girls.
You can't talk to no girls.
Oh, shoot.
Hey, Bree, 6 o'clock.
I know you're not talking about work at a party.
Come on, man. Now you know. Work never stops for people like us.
That's true.
But I'm glad you're here.
Of course. I wouldn't miss it for the world, bro. I mean, you helped me with so many cases. Matter of fact, half of them wouldn't be solved if it wasn't for you, so.
Yeah. Well, I'm going to let y'all get it. I'm going to go tend to the rest of the people in the party.
Hey, Kevin,
so, y'all sure you don't need it?
So, hey, Bree.
Hey, what's up, Q?
Not much. How you been?
I've been good.
That's good. That's good. Tobias?
Huh? Hey, Bree. Yes. It's been a long time.
I'm finally one of the head deputies at the police department. Mm. I mean, it takes more hours of work than ever, but seems worth it.
Yeah, that sounds great.
Okay, so it was nice seeing you. It really, it was. But we're just gonna see who else is at the party, okay?
All right.
All right, come on, man. What are you doing? How's it been 2 years and it's still awkward around you and Bree?
Man, come on. You act like you'd be this chill if your ex showed up.
Who, Desi? But she's not here. We need to be focused on, like you said, these ladies. Is she staring at you?
Bro.
Look. Bro, she's not staring at me. She gotta be staring at you. You need to go talk to her.
Think so?
Yes, bro. Because by the look of things, it's either her or Bree.
Oh, hell.
Go handle that.
Hey, how are you?
I'm good.
Yeah. Saw an unfamiliar face, just figured I'd come over and introduce myself. You're gorgeous. Listen, I know most of the people here at the party, so if you need a drink or if anyone's bullying you, just give me a shout and I'll help you out.
That's cute. Is that supposed to make me feel like I can trust you?
I'm Tobias. And you are?
Not interested.
Oh, you serious? Okay. Mm-hmm.
But it's nice to meet you. Actually, you want to get out of here?
I got you.
Oh.
So would you like to come back to my...
Thank you.
For what?
For... Look, I'm new in town, and my new friends are trying to get me to meet these people.
What's wrong with that?
I prefer to be indoors, with a good book and a dim light.
One of those type, huh?
Yes. So thank you for saving me in there.
I didn't save you. You saved yourself, really. I basically just followed you outside.
Well, this is my ride.
Yeah, but I didn't get your number.
I'll see you around. Maybe.
On Instagram or Snapchat? Come on, you ain't got WhatsApp? And then she just... disappeared.
Wait, you saw Bree at Kevin's renewal? And you still hung up on this mystery woman that vanished into a whip?
Look, man, it's not that simple. She was captivating. Honestly, I've never met anybody that in control of their environment before.
Man, you need to be careful. People don't just show up in a new town for no reason. What'd you say her name was?
I didn't get it.
Love it.
Wait, you mean to tell me Tobias left out the party looking like a sad puppy?
Yes, bro, and that's not even the best part. He didn't even get the girl's number.
I don't know why y'all think this is so funny. I cannot stop thinking about this random woman. I don't even know her name or how to find her.
Okay, now you sound like a stalker.
All right, keep laughing at me. Y'all gonna get yours one day. Watch.
Nah, I'm good.
Is that Desi?
See, not even falling for it, Tobias. I already got that one.
Nah. Hey, Shane. Hey, Tobias.
Oh,
hey,
my
Desi. God. Desi, what a surprise seeing you here.
Oh, thank you.
Shall I put on something tonight?
You see it. This is my girl, Lexi.
Hey, Lexi.
So, what y'all doing tonight?
Shoot, you know, we just chilling because my boy Shane can't get none, so.
Tobias.
This is like my community service for the week.
Shane, don't even worry about it. You're one of the nicest guys I know. Go meet somebody who cares about you. Someone who's not the coward type that runs at the first sign of responsibility.
What? Alexis, why don't you tell my baby mama that I don't run from responsibility? She just never answered the phone when I call.
No. Don't put me in the middle of that. That's between the two of you.
Somebody need to tell her.
Stay out of it.
Extra.
Anyways, Lexi, you and my guy Shane should hook up sometime.
Hey, how you doing?
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
Thank you.
For what?
You just called me beautiful.
No, I didn't.
All right. Calm down, Tiger. Hey, you guys, we gotta get back to the girls. See y'all later.
All right, now, y'all have a good one.
No.
Yeah.
Don't look at it, Quincy.
You don't look.
No matter how much I want to.
Because
how's she gonna talk about me? Call me a deadbeat dad? I take good care of my kids.
Man, how you still gonna be checking for Desi after all this time? You need to let it go.
I can't.
Listen, man, we ain't got no business being in between you and Desi's drama. Y'all got this never-ending, toxic.
Toxic what? What you looking at?
Man, where are you going? I'll be back.
Hey, we not paying for this drink.
Hey, no, girl.
Thank you.
You're
welcome. I needed a drink.
Okay.
Hey.
You.
Yeah, I'm surprised to see you here too.
Tobias, right?
You have a good memory.
I would do anything to get away from this table right now.
You know, I think you still owe me that dance.
I do?
Yeah.
I do. Y'all gonna dance right here?
Yeah, why not? May I have this dance?
Yes. What do you want to know?
How much time you got? Let's maybe start with a name.
Marley.
Marley.
Yeah.
I like that. It's nice to finally officially meet you, Marley. I'm Tobias.
Tobias Carter.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, you seem to be the talk of the town with the women around here.
Okay. Don't do that. I grew up here, and I was kind of a big deal when I was headed to the league.
You were in the league?
I was going.
Okay, so what happened?
Grandma fell ill, and it was either play ball in Baltimore or come back home and take care of family. I'm gonna choose family every time.
No, I get that, that's huge. So why didn't you just take her with you?
Huh. She wasn't leaving Wichita.
Apparently she saw something in here that I didn't.
Hey, don't be coming from my city now. Nah, she wouldn't leave her house. I mean, my granddad built that house for her. It was bare hands.
So, how is she now?
She passed away about 5 years ago.
Sorry to hear that.
It's okay. Just glad she's not in pain anymore, you know?
Definitely.
What about you? How's your family?
Oh, well, my parents are gone. My dad passed away when I was about 10. My mom didn't really take that well. She overdosed on her anxiety meds. So, this place is a vibe.
Oh yeah, you like it?
Yeah, you actually have good taste.
Hey, I'm Nia. I'll be starting you guys out with some drinks, maybe?
Yeah, we'd love that, thank you. Yeah, I'll actually take, I think it's called a Pink Lady.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
And for you?
I'll just have a Blue Moon.
Blue Moon? Are you sure that's what you want?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I will get those drinks for you then.
So, what was that about?
Huh? Oh, her?
Yeah.
Old friend from college.
Okay.
You know, college years was crazy.
So, remind me of what you do again?
Well, I'm an architect for Miller Construction.
So you making a little money out here.
Well, listen, let's just say grandmama ain't raised no dummy, all right?
Okay.
What about you? What do you do for a living?
Well, believe it or not, I sell life insurance. I do.
Life insurance?
Yes.
Why are you playing with me? You don't look like the type.
What does that mean?
Well, look, no offense, but I just figure with all the books that you read and studying you do, maybe you're a professor or a lawyer or solving world hunger or something like that. I just figured.
All right. We have the Pink Lady for the lady.
Thank you.
And the Blue Moon, what you chose. Enjoy.
Thank you. Now, she's not going to spit my drinks or anything, is she?
Hopefully not. Cheers.
Let's.
To what?
To new friends.
To good friends.
To good friends, I'll take it.
In a new town.
In a new town, let's choose again.
I can see you again.
I can see you and me in the future, and I love that you've been introducing me to new.
Cause your love's what I need. do, man.
What's happening, Marley?
Hi, you must be Quincy.
Yes, nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you too. I've heard a lot about you.
Yeah.
All right, y'all can stop shaking hands now, dang.
I was just playing, man. Sorry about our friend. He's in the car. I think he forgot something.
Okay.
He should be in a little.
Yeah, no worries. All come right. on in.
How you been, man?
I've been chilling. You know how work's been. Crazy as always.
We needed a game night.
Yeah, we did. I need to unwind, man.
Hey.
Hi. Must be Marley.
I am. You must be Quincy's friend.
Well, actually, Quincy Antibias' friend.
Excuse me. I'm sorry. Come on in.
Yeah, it's nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you, too. I didn't catch your name.
My name is Shane. Shane. Marley. Are you okay?
I'm sorry. You said your name was Shane?
Yeah, is that okay? Did you kill someone named Shane?
What? Why would you say that?
Matter of fact, no harm, no foul. I was playing. Sorry.
What's going on over here?
What's up, man? Not too much.
What's up, man?
Just introduced myself to your girl, and I think she don't like me already.
No, wait. You were the one that said that your name was...
I was just joking.
Oh, listen, don't worry about Shane here. He likes to push people's buttons. He needs to take his therapist hat off when he's not in the office.
Man, it's hard not to. You know, I wasn't trying to play with your mind or nothing, but he's acting a little triggered. Here's my card if you want to talk about your past.
Shane! Come on, man!
Look, I get it.
I'm just saying.
Just an occupational hazard. Come on in.
What's up,
man? What's up?
Hold up. Wait a minute. We not ready. You said we playing charades, right?
Yes.
And this is a couples game.
Yes. I don't understand.
What you mean? Everybody's here with a boyfriend or girlfriend, except for me. Y'all got me paired up with him.
Come on, bro. It's not that big of a deal.
I'm just as open-minded as the next guy. But hell no. I'm not doing this.
Man, you got
it. Man, what the hell? Man, chill out. See what I'm saying?
We have arrived. We have arrived.
Hello.
Now, which one of y'all are gonna be my charades partner?
I know Shane about to be mine.
Okay, Shane, I see you turtleneck.
No. Shane, my partner.
Man, get up. I need to see you kiss you on the face. Since we met, I've been feeling you. I know it's real. Pulling up when you tell me if you want to chill. Play a game, pour the liquor up. Hey, tell our friends to pull up to the spot. We can get it crunk. Good vibes, it's a good time. I get lost from time to time looking in your eyes. My friends tell me that I need to chill. But I'm feeling you, it feel good, it feels surreal. If you hold me down, I promise I'll always be around. A little kill for a little, do a bid for, don't play around. When I text you outside, I get butterflies. When you hug me, hold me close, chills up my spine. I ain't worried about what haters say. You the one that I want, nothing changed, that's forever, babe.
Thank you for the invitation. Yeah, yeah. And if you get it right, I'ma give you all my love. Never have to ask, you know what I want. You the one I want, yeah. Got me addicted to your love. Your love, your love. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Hey, man, thanks for taking care of my jacket. Sorry about Desi, you know she be tripping.
Yeah, yeah, no problem, sure thing.
You man, good?
At this point, it's sexual harassment. Lexi spilt that drink on me on purpose.
At least yours is sexual, mine's just straight up abuse.
Thanks for coming.
Man, thank you, man. It's been so much fun. We're gonna come back next time. Sorry about my man. You know, he don't take social cues very well.
That's okay.
All right, then.
All right.
All right, Tobias. All right,
you
all
have
right,
a good
Shane.
One.
You too.
Hey,
Shane.
Hey, you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay.
Good.
I'm great.
Good. So, you think your friends like me?
You know, Shane, I'm not so sure about. But Quincy?
Mm.
Oh, Quincy loves you. If I was some other dude, he would have been slitting your DMs trying to ask for your number.
Oh my goodness.
Either that or try to give you a foot massage. That's how it got Desi.
Oh, stop it. Oh, God. So, what about you? Do you like me?
I love you, Marley.
Your vibes unmatched, I love. Always be thinking of it. Whenever we're in public,
so, did you enjoy your party last night?
I did. How about you?
I did. It was nice meeting your friends.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
It's just a good thing that you woke up when you did.
Why is that?
You would have saw nothing but my shirt hanging off the side of the bed.
Shut up.
You hungry? Breakfast?
I am. What are you thinking?
Your kitchen.
Oh, so you can cook.
Well, I mean, I know my way around the egg and skillet. You think I got so big?
Oh, all right. I know that's right. Well, go ahead then.
You see what you got.
All right. Who are you?
Can I borrow your bag?
Are you lost, sir?
And where are your clothes, dude?
Marley! Marley!
What's going on, babe? Okay.
Mom, this homeless man is in our house with no clothes on. Should I call the police?
No. Why did your aunt drop you guys off so early? You're not supposed to be here for another 3 hours.
She had an urgent case matter she had to handle, so she had to drop us off now.
All right, well, just go get settled downstairs, and I will come meet you.
And go put a shirt on, dude. You even got muscles like that.
Okay, just let me start from the beginning.
You have kids.
Yes, but I...
And not just one, but two kids.
Tobias, slow down.
And one's a teenager, like...
Listen, I know where you're going with this, and this isn't that.
You lied to me.
I just didn't tell you.
It's the same thing. You could have told me about this.
It's not that simple, babe, please.
Not that simple? We've been together for 3 months, and not once have your children come up.
Tobias,
gotta go.
Tobias, please.
What'd I miss?
Tobias, in love with a woman? They got two children.
What? Marley got two kids?
Yeah.
With a body like that? She's still fine.
Come on, man. That's what you say?
What? Y'all know she fine as hell. And with a body like that after two kids? Give me that bath water.
Quincy, chill, bro. You not helping at all.
Just saying, I look on the bright side.
So that mean you settle for less?
No, Tobias is a grown man. All I'm saying is, I think he can handle himself.
So you mean to tell me you can be with a woman with two kids? And not just that, she lied about the information for 3 months. Answer me honestly.
Love is one of those things, it's like looking into the other side of a mirror. You don't know if they feel the way you feel or hurt the way you hurt or even want to be there in general.
See, this is what I'm talking about. What you saying makes no sense at all.
It kind of does, bro.
All right, I'm out.
Where you going?
Yo, I'm out. It's Saturday, and this is not a session. I called y'all up here because I wanted to talk to my boys, not listen to y'all go back and forth sounding stupid.
All right, calm down, because I left the meeting with the fantasy football team just to be with y'all, too. At least you can do is relax. Hear us out.
Hey, I'm sorry.
See, at least he apologized. Come on.
Man, I guess I'm just tripping because...
But I still don't like the chick, though.
Hey, dumbass. You could have kept that information to yourself. Tobias came to us in confidence. You know how hard that was for him. The least we could do is cut him some slack.
So you mean to tell me there's something not off about her?
You're not even listening. Tell me again. How'd you become a therapist?
Before I moved here, I promised myself that I would make an easy transition for my kids. I wanted to get here and get established and get to know the people in the city. And so they've been staying with my sister back home. I didn't expect to meet anybody here. There were so many times that I wanted to tell you, and I could not find the perfect time. I just wanted to be in the moment with you. My intention was not to hurt you.
Come here.
I'm so sorry, Tobias.
I love you.
I love you too. And I love my kids.
Walk with me to my new office or what?
Sure, let's go.
All right. Hey. See, that's why I got the promotion and you didn't.
Hey, you know the first thing you should do?
What?
Get some new chairs for everybody.
Well, if you can find me some new chair money, maybe I'll do that.
Hey, because you know you're in charge of the budget now.
Okay, then I'll put them on back order. Don't worry about it.
There you go.
Oh, Simpson. Green. How's home?
You know, it's actually a lot better. It was rough in the beginning, but I'm starting to feel like myself again.
That's good, because you know, this job is a job you can't afford to make any mistakes in.
That's very true, and I'm trying my best not to make any, let me tell you.
That's good. How's Buddy?
Oh, Buddy, I couldn't care less how Buddy is. That's how it is, but okay. Hey, I gotta catch this meeting, so I'll catch you later, though.
All right, cool.
All right.
Congratulations again.
Thank you. Feet off my desk. Acting like you ain't got no kind of home training. What's wrong with you?
What's up, Bree?
Not
new
much
office, much. New job, same old attitude.
Yes, sir, you know it. But I really do appreciate you for coming out on such short notice.
Yeah, well, I mean, you sounded desperate, so.
Oh, not at all.
Well, I know you do call me whenever you need a fresh set of eyes on these cases.
Okay, you are like the only person who can help me on this case. You know I got a target on my back? I get the worst cases in the entire department. And what's worse is I don't know if it's because I'm black or if it's because I'm a woman.
Now listen, you're the most impressive officer that I know. But enough with the small talk, let's cut to the business. Why am I here?
Well, I actually got permission from my boss this time, so we're officially doing this.
Like we can officially like work together?
Absolutely, I got permission, I told you.
Yo, okay, so let me get an AK. I also want a semi-automatic. Let me get that. And then,
I need you to focus on the case. Bring it back in and focus.
All right. I don't understand this case. We got a suspect where nothing is sticking to them. And we have a victim that's a dead end.
We got a suspect who's claiming he's the victim.
What?
The first victim's son is claiming that his stepmom killed his father.
But
his dad died of cancer.
Okay, that's pretty easy. he doesn't want to accept his father's death.
See, that's what I thought. Natalie remarried 3 months after the boy's father died. Then her new husband dies 3 months after the wedding? I mean, that's the exact same time frame that her first husband died in. Once is chance, twice is coincidence.
Three is a pattern.
Exactly.
So the third husband dies 3 months after they get married again. That doesn't mean she's killing him. Now, she could be very calculated on when they're gonna die, but I am a little bit suspicious of this 3 month time frame because that doesn't seem like much of a coincidence.
Exactly.
But Natalie's dead.
She vanished. Everything was in her favor with this case, and then suddenly she's just nowhere to be found. And what's even crazier is that Richard's son.
From the first marriage.
Right. She claims that he was obsessed with her. Richard's son claims that Natalie killed all of her husbands to collect their inheritance. And then we open the case and they all disappear?
Nobody in the department wanted this case, so they dropped it on you, right? I need you to tell me something. I need you to be honest with me, Bree. Why did you guys reopen this case?
I can't tell you that.
What kind of job do you have?
Oh, well, I'm an architect. I work for a company called Miller Construction.
Can you fight? Oh, that means you build stuff.
Well, sort of. I design the projects that my company builds.
So that means you make a lot of money.
Aria, that is not your business.
Mom, Auntie Skylar said we should be dealing with men of high value.
Ooh, sounds like Auntie Skylar been watching too much YouTube.
Are you a high value man?
Well, I mean, I'm high value in spirit, and that's all that should matter. Listen, Aria, seriously, let's say that your mom ever wanted something. She'd get it. There isn't anything that I wouldn't do for her. Or the ones that she loves.
That's cute, but can you fight, though?
Well, I'm about to fight you.
That is green juice. Act like you've been somewhere.
What'd you do, grind up a salad?
Okay. Sky, you play too much.
Finish it. Shut your glass and it's good for you.
Okay. Okay with me.
Speaking of what's good, I heard the kids talking about some guy.
Some guy with you?
His name is Tony.
I think they meant Tobias.
Right, Tobias.
Uh-huh. Tell me about him. Tobias is like a mix between Sidney Poitier and Andre 3000.
He looked like Lakeith Stanfield.
No, but kind of. Look, no, sis, really what I'm talking about is his mannerisms. The way he moves, his sexy, fit body, his politeness, yet his masculine tone. Honestly, I have never experienced a man like him before.
You hitting deep with this one.
Okay, here you go.
His mannerisms.
Yes.
His energy. Are you sure you're ready to take it to the next level with this one?
Why would you ask me that?
If I know you like I believe I do, you know I do. You have a habit of rushing into relationships with these guys without getting to know them first, especially after everything you just went through.
Look, Scott, you don't think that I can handle my emotions and this relationship? I handled the death of our father at 9 years old. Come on. I think I can handle a man exiting my life if he so chooses.
So that's it, sis. You have daddy issues.
Okay.
That's crazy. Because mom treated dad like she owed him her life. She always said dad was this handsome debonair like Tobias. Dad was the worst example of a man.
He was.
A leader. He wouldn't recognize a real queen standing next to him if it slapped him square in the face.
This doesn't take one of your TED Talks to convince me that I have this under control. See, he knows what he has with me.
But does he know what he loses if it doesn't work out?
He's not like that.
Let's hope not. I just refuse to see you turned out like Mom, not fighting for your life or your kids.
Hello, hello.
So this man just walking into your house?
He has a key.
A key? Molly, are you serious? What's going on?
Oh, hey. You must be Skylar. Sky, right? I'm Tobias.
Yeah, I'm Skylar.
Oh, babe. She's just as sweet as you said she'd be.
Sweet? Let's get something straight. My sis has a habit of picking up clowns that like to play games. I don't play games, especially with clowns. So tell me, Terrence.
Tobias.
Are you a clown?
Come on, I was just playing.
Games, right?
Skylar.
Oh my goodness, you see what you did?
Sky.
Are we in the party phase of our relationship?
Well, me and you and Sky is.
Oh.
I said
that. Come on.
Hey, Mama.
Trey, hi, how are you?
I'm good. How about you?
I'm good. It's nice to see you.
I've been waiting to see you.
Oh, okay.
You see, I've been giving us some space since your first marriage didn't work out. Figured you needed time to mourn and deal with the loss.
I'm sorry, time to mourn for?
For us to be together. What's funny?
You, that was a good one, son.
I'm not your son, Marley. I've never been your son. We're only 8 years apart. Your kids were toddlers at that time and I was 19. Did you really think I'd respect you in that position being this close in age to me?
Trey, look, I didn't know you felt that way.
It's all good. So can I take you out sometime? There's this restaurant up the street that's so...
No, I don't think you're understanding. It's not happening.
No.
Yeah, like, no. Nuh-uh. I married your father. And regardless of him passing, you're like a son to me.
Listen, either you go out on a date with me or I'm going to tell the truth about you to your new boyfriend. Think I won't do it? I know you go to the gym promptly at 5:30 every morning. You go to the one right on Rock Road, right? It's Tuesday, so you focused on abs today. Tomorrow's legs. I love leg day. Also, you make that vegan cheese dip top with the green onions. Tobias comes home around 7. You guys are in bed 9:30.
Why are you doing this?
Because I also know the truth of what happened to my father, and so do you. Now, should I pick you up at 7 or 7:30?
Thank you.
Hey, Marley.
Hey, Shane.
Didn't expect to see you here.
Yeah, no, I didn't expect to see you either.
Why you look so flustered? Who was that guy I seen you speaking with?
Nobody. Nobody important.
Nobody important? Are you sure? I shouldn't notify the authorities
of
Tobias, man.
No, absolutely not. Shane, everything is fine, okay? Have a good day.
Okay.
Oh, I got something for y'all. Any, many, miny, mo. Catch a tiger by the toe. If he hollers, let him go. Yeah. Any, many, miny, mo. Catch a tiger by the toe. If he hollers, let him go. Sing it, girl.
Loving every day.
Tiger by the toe, rapping hollers, let him go. Eeny, meeny, miny, mo. Yeah, one more time. Eeny, meeny, miny, mo. Catch a tiger by the toe, rapping hollers, let him go. We did that.
Yeah. Wow, thank you, ladies. That was lovely. Anyway, I do want to thank everybody for coming out tonight. Especially want to thank Marley for letting me do this, signing my permission slip, making sure that this night happened. I love you, baby. Can we get a round of applause for Marley? Thank you. You deserve it, baby. You deserve the world.
All the world.
Which is why I want to know if you'll let me be the person to give that to you. Marley, since the day that I met you, you've knocked me down. You've made me wonder how I'm supposed to breathe with no air. And I like it, so I'm going to put a ring on it. Marley, will you marry me?
Hey, you having a good night? It's about to get even better. hey, girl, won't you come dance with me? You're about to get married.
No, thank you. No, thank you. What?
Yo, Quincy, man, what are you doing?
What?
Yo, this is my engagement party, not my bachelor party.
Man, more for me. Excuse me. He had his thing.
Okay.
Yeah, they call me cute.
Oh, cute.
Yeah. Hello. Yeah. Okay.
What's up?
What?
Really?
Man.
So you just gonna dance with a chick right in front of me?
We're not even together.
Our six-year-old daughter would beg a differ.
Oh. What the hell, Desi? Nah, Desi! Don't walk away! Desi!
Girl, I am so happy for you and Tobias. It is giving Jay-Z and Beyonce, baby.
All right.
Except for Tobias is a little bit more handsome.
Oh, that part.
Yes.
Nah, but thank you.
You're welcome.
That man never ceases to amaze me.
It's only a matter of time before Shane surprises me. That man is so fine. Mm.
Girl, you know he is not into you like that, right?
Not yet.
Wearing him down, I guess.
Mm. I'm showing.
Anyways, I cannot wait until I'm proposed to again.
Again?
Yeah, Quincy proposed to me at high school prom. We was engaged for like 8 years. That don't count.
That's true though. That is way too.
Girl, I don't know, but he does this trick with my toes, and that's how he got me. I ain't gonna lie to you. I'm so good.
And we're gonna have some beautiful caramel bagels. Don't worry.
Are you okay? Like, okay? Yes. Like, did you get a check?
Hey, what's going on, Kevin? Yeah, I mean, just going back to the conversation about Marley, man. You should have seen her at game night. Yeah, she flipped out when I told her my name. Apparently, her ex-husband and I, we both got the same name. Yeah, but she seemed timid, though. And I also seen her at the bank talking to some younger dude with dreads and had the same look on her face. Listen, just do me a favor. Matter of fact, do Tobias a favor and just check her out for me, please. Yeah, see, that's all I'm asking. Thank you. No, I get it. I get it. You're good, bro. All right.
What up, man?
So you wasn't thinking about telling your best friend that you was gonna propose to this woman?
Oh, come on, man, you know I wanted to. But this is just something I had to figure out on my own.
Tobias, what do you really know about this woman? She could be a witch doctor. Put a root on you or something. Or she could be running from something in her past.
Yeah, well, we're all running from something, Shane. Remember, you're the one who told me that. You know, maybe it's time that you sat down with somebody like yourself.
Listen, I'm your boy, but 6 months just feels too fast, man.
Brother, I'm already too far gone.
Thanks for breakfast, babe. It was amazing.
Yes. I'll take that from you.
Thank you.
Okay. Aria has volleyball practice today, and Jackson's gonna stay after school with a friend, so I'm gonna go take her to that.
Okay, cool. All right. Oh, I forgot to warm up my car. I'm sorry, babe.
Okay.
I'll be right back.
Hey, go build something great, okay?
Thank you, baby.
Okay.
Yo, yo, good morning, Q. Hey, what's first on the schedule today? I think I might have double booked myself. Here you go.
What? Look, bro, you and Des always going through some sort of drama, man. How am I supposed to take any of that seriously? Yeah, but man, you
Hold on, Chris, we'll be calling you back.
I think this is the doctor now. Okay, I'm gonna give you a call back. All right, bye. Oh, thank God. Come here. Oh, is he okay?
He had me concerned earlier, but once his vitals began leveling out, I knew he'd be okay.
Let me guess, carbon monoxide poisoning?
Hardly. You got the garage door open just in time. Otherwise, I'd be having this conversation with your wife. We ran some tests, you should be fine. Just make sure you get plenty of fresh air, do some deep breathing exercises, and I'll follow up with you in about 2 weeks.
Okay, is there anything I can do to help him at home?
Sure, I'll write it down for you.
You and Jackson seem to be getting pretty close.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. You're pretty good at this.
Well, you know, football is my big passion.
Yeah, no, I meant the kids.
Oh.
So you haven't done this before?
What? Not that I know of.
Okay. Hey, Tobias.
What up?
I bet you can't throw it deep.
How much you want to bet?
$20.
Well, I hope your mama got cash because you're about to lose your money.
Hey.
Marley, is it?
Yes.
So you want to tell me what happened here?
Ma'am,
I understand you're still in shock. I mean, getting the first reports helps go a long way with our case. I mean, we want to catch this bastard, right?
Of course I do.
So tell me what happened.
But I was...
Hey. You just can't let someone in here in the middle of the investigation.
It's Shane. What's up, man? Nah, it's Tobias, man. Got beat up.
All right, then.
So, y'all want me to believe this? You said you just pulled up right when he was getting assaulted.
Yes.
You said you were so deep in your sleep that you didn't know he was being assaulted by anyone?
Right.
And you?
Man, what?
You said that there was someone else in the house besides you, but no one else seen anyone. I mean, Quincy was right in front of the house when you fell.
When I was attacked?
Okay, so when you were attacked by this entity that no one seen but you?
Look, dude, you're either saying that I don't know what happened to me, or you're trying to say that I'm making all of this up. One means you think I'm delusional. The other means that you think I'm a liar. So which one is it?
The truth. Tell me the truth.
Okay, so then how did I get this?
You fell. You hit your head, which gave you a concussion. Which possibly gave you visual hallucinations. So, Quincy, why were you here so early?
So I had to get some documents from Tobias. I mean, I know it's his honeymoon and everything. Sorry, guys. It's okay. But he was supposed to submit those documents last week. He said he's gonna drop them off earlier, but I decided to come to save him some time, so I came.
Finally. First time it feels like someone's telling me the truth around here.
Thank you.
Hey, Bree, what's going on? Can you hear me? Okay, listen, I got something. Natalie Frazier. Frazier not being the last name of any of her husbands, right? She's squeaky clean. The only coincidence that's there is that they're all dying 3 months after they get married to her, right? Seems like a coincidence. Check this out. After going through all those files, I ran across some bank statements. Natalie Frazier transferred a large lump sum of money to someone named Tina F. F? Frazier? Tina Frazier, Natalie Frazier, maybe they're related. Think it's another coincidence. Get this. Just a few weeks later, Tina F. transfers that same amount of money to someone else. You will never believe who this other person is.
This is true.
Absolutely asinine. I'm getting something from the spirit. Oh, 13 and 3/4 of a sheet, precisely.
Chill. What is the point of this game?
Girl, we get to your baby bump.
Evening, Tobias. Marley Carter, AKA Natalie Dawson. You're under arrest on the suspicion of murder and fraud. Anything you say can and will be held against you in a court of law.
Wait, hold on, Natalie Dawson? Bree, what are you doing?
Tobias, please don't make this harder than it already is.
What are you clearly this is a mistake.
What are you gonna do, get in the car with this?
Jackson, go get your sister and call Skylar.
I'm calling Bias on this case. There is no reason you should be on this.
And you're not really in a position to be telling me what cases I should or shouldn't be taking, so.
You're Tobias's ex. And honestly, I can see why.
You're trying to knock me off my square. Well, it's not gonna work. So how about I take it from the top and start asking you the questions? First question being, what should I call you? Marley Carter or Natalie Dawson? Oh, we're not cooperating. Wow, I genuinely thought you were gonna help me out here. But that's okay. I don't mind playing hardball.
Marley, don't say another word. I'm her lawyer. My client has been wrongfully arrested. She has changed her name to protect herself from a violent and dangerous individual. And if you want to take this to court, we are more than prepared to do so.
Uncuff her.
Yeah, and if you have anything further, feel free to contact me. Let's go, Marley. Bye, Bree. I'll see you later.
Tobias, this woman got arrested for murder and fraud. People don't do that mistakenly.
Obviously, in this case, it was a mistake.
Marley has skeletons, and I told you that.
Bro, what is it with you and all this hate towards Marley?
It's not hate. That's not what this is. I just clearly see something that my best friend don't see.
I don't know, Shane. Tobias is happy. I don't think you should be giving him the third degree.
Whatever, man. Look, I'm the one that told you about Little Dreadlock. I see this dude everywhere I go. The bar, the bank, the wedding. You know, she probably sleeping with Little Dreadlock, too.
Watch how the hell are you talking about my wife, man?
Come on, bro. Chill, y'all. We still boys.
What's wrong with you?
Come on.
You can go to hell, Shane. Mm-hmm. Only person you know how to be happy for is yourself.
Come on, T.
I don't know if this is the right profession for you, bro. Because you're not good at it. Best friend. Going to the bathroom.
What? What, Quincy?
Why are you acting jealous? And if you're not jealous, then why are you in this man's business like somebody's baby mama? Trust me, I should know.
Okay. I'm through with it then. I'm through.
And then Mr. Tobias' keys. Where are you going?
Tell Tobias I'll be back. I got a run to make. My car's in the shop. 5 minutes.
So you gonna take this man's keys after you done pissed him off for real?
Whatever, man.
Hey, we're looking for Shane. Shane Davidson.
Sir, you can't go back there.
Whoa, you can't go back there.
Yo, that's my brother back there.
I get that, but the doctors are doing everything they can to save his life. You're gonna have to wait until visitors are accepted.
But at least is he okay?
The police will be here to ask you some questions shortly.
He has to be okay.
Listen, I'll let you know when he's out of surgery. Thank you.
He's gonna be all right, man. He's gonna be all right. He's gonna be all right. He's gonna be all right.
Are you the family of Shane Davidson?
Yes.
He's out of surgery and he's recovering. He suffered from a concussion, a few broken ribs, lacerations to the neck, and a ruptured spleen. I'm glad you got to him when you did. He's gonna need to rest now though.
It's okay, I'll wait.
Excuse me, miss.
Yes.
How's he doing back there?
Okay, so he's gonna need some rest, but you can come back when he has some more energy to talk.
Okay, I'll just wait. Okay. Thank you for taking care of him.
Of course. Wait, sir. I was gonna wait for the police to get here before mentioning this, but on the way back to surgery, Shane kept repeating this name, Little Dreadlock. I'm not sure what that means, but I figured I'd let you know.
I'm gonna go get the kids, okay, babe? All
right. All right, kids. See you later.
Marley. Mm-hmm.
Not today, Sky. All right, fine.
What's going on, Bree?
What's up, Kev?
Not a whole lot. Listen, I think I got a lead on this case. I wanted to know if you wanted to tag along with me.
Kevin, the chief is really up my behind, and I can't tag along with you, man. I'm sorry.
All right, no, it's cool. Hey, I'll keep you posted on everything that's happening, though, okay?
All right, bet.
All right.
Thank you. Bye.
A very clean and well-maintained facility. As you can imagine, we have a pretty wealthy clientele that bring their loved ones here, so we want to take really good care of them. I was surprised to get your phone call that you're visiting. Mrs. Frazier doesn't normally get a lot of visitors.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, surely she has family.
She does, but the two daughters that she has, they haven't visited in years.
Can I see her?
Yeah, definitely. She's out on the patio. Hi, Miss Frazier. You have a visitor.
Hi, Mrs. Frazier. I'm Kevin. I'm actually acquainted with your daughter, Marley. Funny thing is, Marley is actually married to one of my good friends. I have a few questions, if you don't mind. Marley said her parents were dead. Clearly, you're not dead, but, listen, I got this case that came across my desk, and I have a few holes in it. Maybe you could help. I know your husband was an alcoholic. I know he was verbally and physically abusive. Mrs. Frazier, I need to know what happened that night. I need to know why your husband ended up with a knife in his back.
Okay, Mr. Kevin, Mrs. Frazier needs medicine and nap time. Can you maybe come back and visit another time?
Yeah.
Yo,
Tobias, man, what's good?
I catch you at a bad time?
Man, just grabbing some food. What's going on?
Hey, man, I gotta tell you something. I've been investigating your wife.
What?
You've been investigating Marley. Why the hell would you be investigating my wife for?
Listen, man, Shane approached me a while back with some genuine concerns.
And asked me to look into it, so...
He had you investigating my wife without even talking to me first? You know what? Just stop, Kevin, stop. This has gone on for long enough, all right?
Listen, bruh, I got something to tell you.
Stop investigating my wife, Kev.
Wait, no, Tobias. Tobias, hello?
Hello?
Marley, I need you to come down to the station. We have some questions regarding Trey's death. We found Trey's body earlier today. Looks like foul play, and we need to tie up some loose ends.
Marley, I genuinely appreciate your cooperation here. Okay, I'm gonna ask you a few questions, and it's important to note that I am just trying to figure out the facts and close this case.
Listen, you don't have to answer any of these questions, Marley.
As you're aware, we've been investigating the murder of your alleged stalker, Trey, that happened last Friday, and I just want to know your whereabouts during that time.
Just to clarify, Detective, my client is here voluntarily. She'll answer your questions. However, I'd advise her to fully exercise her rights if needed.
Are you okay to proceed?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. Could you give me a detailed account of your activities the evening that Trey died?
Tobias and I were at the hospital most of the night. I mean, that was the same day that Shane got hurt.
And around what time did you say that you left the hospital?
We left around...
Hey, I'm sorry, I had to take this. Are you okay if I step out?
Yeah.
Okay.
Like I was saying, where were you headed after you left the hospital?
I think we went, hello, I'm in a meeting.
Okay, all right, I'll be right there.
Sorry, sis, there's an urgent matter at the office. I have to head out, but I'll be back as soon as I can, okay?
Okay.
All right. Hey, your rights. And call me if you have any concerns.
Okay.
Now that everybody is gone, how do you really feel now that your stalker is out of the picture?
I mean, he was a good kid. He was just misled.
Well, I don't have any more questions for you. I could drive you home if you'd like.
Yeah.
So what the hell was so important that we had to meet right now, Kevin?
Tobias, I know you're upset right now. I got information.
Information that's more important than you violating my wife's privacy?
Tobias, Marley's mother is still alive. I just took a trip out to Kansas City and visited her at a nursing home.
You're wrong. Marley told me that her parents were gone. Her mother... Mother OD'd on her anxiety meds.
I know this might be a little hard to digest. Records don't lie. She's been at that nursing home for years. She even takes her kids up there sometimes.
Why would she lie to me about this? Shane's in the hospital. The police? What's going on, Kevin?
Listen, man, I don't have all the answers. Not yet. Maybe Marley was trying to keep that from you for a reason. Maybe she had good reason. I don't know. All I know is it's on you if you want to keep digging.
I don't know how many more questions I could ask about this case, but honestly, I'm about over it. There's nothing else I can really look into, so I think I'm gonna just go ahead and head home.
Yeah, well, good luck.
All right, thank you so much.
Oh,
I've been meaning to congratulate you and Tobias on your wedding. That's pretty dope.
You don't have to do that.
Do what?
Congratulate us. I mean, you're his ex. We don't need your rubber stamp of approval on our relationship. Let's just keep that where it is.
Okay.
Smells good.
Thank you. It's a little recipe I'm trying.
Yeah, how'd it go down at the precinct?
You know, pretty good. It's cool. I think Bree may have a crush on me. How'd it go with you and Kip?
It's cool.
What you guys talk about?
A little bit of this, a little bit of that.
Something on your mind?
Yeah, actually there is. You know, I don't want to say anything in front of the kids, but Kevin said he just got back from Kansas City, visiting a nursing home where apparently your mother lives. At least according to him.
Tobias, sit down.
Marley, after the kid situation, you told me that we were in this together. No more lies.
Tobias. Yes. My mom is alive. Why is Kevin investigating me? Why do you know this information? Guess I better tell you then. My dad was a drunk. He'd come home every night in some kind of rage. And he'd either take it out on me, my mom, or my sister. He was always mad about something. Whether he lost another job or lost at the casino, I mean, who knew what it was that day? One night he came home, so mad, in fact, that my stomach dropped when I saw him. Just could not believe that there was no one there to protect us. Then he had the audacity to grab a beer from the fridge, sit down at the table to enjoy a meal my mother slaved over. I guess, you know, I don't know what he was mad about. I mean, he decided that night he was gonna put hands on my mom. I couldn't believe it. All I remember is a single tear rolling down my mother's cheek. And at 9 years old, all I can remember is closing my eyes And when I opened them, a knife was to his back. You know, it's funny how trauma has a way of repeating itself. I just never thought the cycle would continue. With you.
Sup, Kev?
Bree, are you still questioning Marley?
No, I just dropped her off at home. Why?
Listen, I have a theory and I think you need to hear this. All right, so Marley's mother is alive and she's in Kansas City. That's who Tina Frazier is, the one receiving money from her.
Okay.
The amount of money being transferred is like six figures. Marley sells life insurance. She's not making that type of money, but when your husband dies and he has life insurance that you set him up with.
Then you have a reason to commit multiple murders, but wait a minute. How would she be committing all these crimes if she's not physically there?
Because, Bree, she's not. It's her kids.
Get them.
Jackson, we need to get Arya to a hospital. Jackson! Ah!
You men. You know you're all the same. Distracted by a pretty face. Do you even actually know me? Oh, and you know what? About your boy Shane. Yeah, no, that wasn't supposed to shake out like that.
I also know the truth of what happened to my father, and so do you. Now, should I pick you up at 7 or 7:30?
You don't think I know that you've been following me since my first husband, my second husband, and my last one? Please, I've had you marked since day one. So you may want to think twice when you think you got one up on somebody. Coming to think that you're trying to intimidate me. Oh, and listen, I heard about your mother. I guess people should stay away from those stairs, huh? Yeah, you took that pretty hard. Now listen, here's just how this is gonna work. If you want something from me, I need you to do something for me.
You know what, fun fact, that was supposed to be you. So you can imagine, to my surprise, when I pull up to the hospital and it's not. Trey didn't get it. My father didn't get it. Imagine that. He just got in the way. You know, kind of like you did. When you got too nosy and you started digging into my past, all you had to do was mind your business. But here we are. You know, I would say that I'm sorry. But you did this to yourself.
Marley, drop your weapon! Marley, don't!
Oh my God, Tobias! Did they get you? Did she get you? You all right? No, don't move, don't move. Lay back. All right, we're gonna need an ambulance out to 707.
Q, what's up, man?
Yo, T. Man, nothing, man. Desi, say hi.
Hey, Desi.
Man, what's up?
Man, you know how it's going. I'm just getting readjusted to single life. Back on the hunt for the one. I still kind of miss her sometimes.
Tobias, turn the news on. You see this?
All right, what?
Turn it to channel 7.
Good morning and thanks for joining us. I'm Alessandra Hill, and here is your top story.
The police are in search of an adolescent male who escaped from the local detention center. His name is Jackson Brooks, also known as Jackson Frazier. He was detained earlier this month with his mother, Marley Brooks, who currently awaits trial on 3 counts of murder and 1 count of attempted murder. Nicole Baxter is on location with more details on this case. Nicole?
Thank you, Alessandra. I'm Nicole Baxter with VNN, reporting live from the Sedgwick County Courthouse. With me today is Skylar Frazier, the sister and attorney of the alleged murderer, Marley Brooks. Skylar, we received updates that your nephew, Jackson, escaped from the juvenile detention center. Do you have any comments?
Well, with my client, Jackson, we are working diligently to locate his whereabouts so that he can be safely returned to the facility with proper supervision.
And regarding the case with your sister, Marley Brooks?
As far as Marley, my client, goes,
she endured a lot of childhood trauma, so we are fighting this case so that she can receive the proper care
and treatment in a facility where she can heal. And we will continue to fight this case until all loose ends are tied and justice is served.
Marley Brooks is currently standing trial for the murder of her late husband and the attempted murder of her recent husband, Tobias Carter. There hasn't been any updates regarding Marley Brooks' son Jackson's escape from the juvenile detention center, but we plan to follow this case as the story progresses. I'm Nicole Baxter with VNN. Back to you, Alessandra.
Thanks, Nicole. In other news, Harrison
Tobias.
Spotted out several...
Hello? Tobias! Hello?
They try to tell me to slow down, but I'm way too far gone. Yeah. I'm way too far gone. Yeah. I'm way too far gone.
I'm way too far.
I'm way
they try to tell me to slow down, but
I'm way too far gone.
Way too far.
I'm way too far gone.
Way too far gone.
I'm way too far gone.
Way too far gone.
Way too,
I'm in my prime.
I'm in my prime.
Gotta go and get mine. Can't waste no time. This opportunity is way too hard to find. Yeah. And it had to run on me. I miss the nights with my homies.
My
and I had to worry about nothing. So them demons got a hold on me.
Then I said to myself, move around.
Gotta move around.
Now I'm way too gone. Ain't no way I'm slowing down.
I ain't slowing down. Tell me to slow down, but I.
Way too far gone.
Said I'm way too far gone.
Way too far gone.
Said I'm way too far gone.
Way too far.
Said I'm way too far
gone.
For a letter, do a bid for it, don't play around. When I text you outside, I get butterflies. When you hug me, hold me close, chills up my spine. I ain't worried about what haters say. You the one that I want, nothing changed, that's forever, babe.